talk about microphone impedance here for a minute. Now, impedance is a term that most of the time you really don't have to be concerned with, because a lot of microphones mismatch impedance with consoles and stuff don't happen anymore. But there's all kinds of microphones, just like how we talked about there was dynamics and condensers. Those are like the basic ways that microphones take acoustical energy and change it into electrical energy. There's all kinds of specific microphones. You know, if you go to somebody's house and you hit their doorbell, their intercom system, the microphone is probably a speaker. They're probably using the speaker both ways. When you push the button one way, it becomes a microphone and you talk into it and they can hear you upstairs. And then when they push the button, it turns back into a speaker and you can hear them. There's other microphones, like the one I'm wearing is a specific use microphone. The impedance of this is high impedance, okay? These are low impedance. These are 600 ohms. And the ohm symbol being the Greek omega sign. So if you see on your microphone the Greek omega sign, if you're doing records and you're doing recording with Pro Tools and stuff, those are the microphones you want to use. 600 ohm microphones are what you want to use. Those are the ones that you're not going to have a mismatch. Now, what happens when you have an impedance mismatch? That's like the camera being blurry. Whenever you hook microphones up with consoles, and if you take, say, a microphone like this and you plug it into not a XLR input but a quarter inch input, you're taking a low impedance microphone and plugging it into a high impedance input, and that's a mismatch. Okay, and what happens is, remember how we talked about phase and a set of frequencies just automatically disappearing? Your sound gets like that, you start to lose level, it's just a mismatch. The best way I can describe it is a picture being blurry and not being clear and crisp. So you want to be careful with buying microphones and buying the right kind of microphones for the specific use that you're going to be using them for. Like, I wouldn't use this lavalier on a Marshall stack. You know what I mean? I might use it on an acoustic guitar because it's, I'm going to talk about this later, it's the pickup pattern it has. But it's the level and the impedance, how I plug it into a console, I have to be careful with. I might have to use an input transformer or direct box. Okay, that's what we use direct boxes for. I have a direct box here. The output of guitars, okay? These are high impedance. These are real high impedance coming just out of a guitar. And we have to use a direct box. It's got a transformer in it, and it transforms the high impedance into a low impedance load so it can go into a microphone pre. And so that's another example of impedance in the real world that you can really kind of understand. Direct boxes, microphones. 600 ohms is what we're trying to achieve. That's Highway 66. All right, that's impedance. I'm going to come back next, and we're going to talk about microphone patterns. Just like all microphones have diaphragms and they convert acoustical energy into electrical energy, not all microphones have the same pickup pattern or polar pattern. And I'll be back with that in a minute. Peace.